Hi everyone, I am Mamta Mittal. Welcome to Art Explorer Academy.
Take a paper, keep it in the horizontal position, and then make the lines, one in the middle of the paper and two lines like this with the scale. And our crayons keep on breaking. So how to make use of the crayon? It is difficult to hold a crayon like this because it is very small and it is already broken. So you have used it, right? So this session is about how to make use of the old crayons. Okay, so we will take small crayon and we are going to make this today. So we will see how we are going to make this. So the old crayons are also useful. So how we will make use of it? So we will just keep the crayon like this on the paper and just rub it against the paper like this. Okay. So this is one on the right side and one on the left side. So I just made a U. So it's a cabbage. So I will just complete it. Okay. Okay. So let's move on. Yes. You can't hear me, but I'm on unmute. So I feel that everybody can hear me. So there is some disturbance at your end. Okay. So you need to check your internet connection. So let's move on and make few more leaves like this. Few more like this. Okay, so our cabbage is a very leafy vegetable. Okay, so it has a lot of leaves. So I just, and then one line in the middle and another line in the middle. So it gives a very beautiful shape. Okay, so to define the shape, let's make use of the another color. So you can use light green as well as dark green. So both are okay. Okay, so now I'm using the light green color and I'm just defining the shape of the leaves. So everywhere I just made the line using the light green color. Okay, so you have to do it slowly, otherwise it will slip out of your hand because it is quite small. Okay. So because I made it in a small area, so the shape got little distorted. So you have to just turn it from here and then go up. So I'll show you with the darker color. Yeah, so I'm just repeating it once again. So I just made a U from here like this, and you have to hold your crayon like this. So you have to rub it against the paper. Okay. So now I'm just making the defining lines with the dark green color so that you can understand better. So I'm just giving it more shape. So it should be like this actually. Okay, so this is how it is. So let's move on to the another shape. So try to make a papaya. So I'll make it with the light green color. So just make a papaya like this. Okay, so papaya is little fat from the bottom and thin from the top. Like this. Okay, so I'm just making the stem with the dark green color and I'll add few coloring in the Okay, so now I'll add few highlights with the light green color like this. Okay, so this is just to define the shape. So this is our papaya. Okay, so you can make half papaya with the yellow and orange. Okay, so this was our papaya, and so I'll just take the orange color and yellow color and red a little bit. Okay, so I'll make a so just making a slice of papaya like this. So you hold the color like this and add few layer of yellow color. Okay, and then few dots of black. So black dots you can add with the black color like this. So these are the seeds of papaya. So this is a papaya slice. Okay, so there are a lot of seeds actually. So this is how our papaya looks. So I'll just make the edges little sharp. So I hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, just write it in the chat box. So I'm going to make a strawberry now. So let's make a strawberry. Our papaya is done. So take a red color and hold it like this. And just you have to just leave the space and you have to rub it like this. Okay. So you can see the texture of the color. So it looks very beautiful. So I'll just make another one inside. So this is going, you have to apply a little pressure, otherwise it will not work. Okay. So you have to apply a little pressure. So like this, and with the green color, I'll make the lines, and the yellow color, and just keep the color horizontal and just rub it against the paper. So you will get it. Okay, so the strawberry is looking very beautiful. Just look at it. Okay, so you can just make some line and then to define the shape of the strawberry like this. Okay, so this was our third one. And now we can make a lotus or a tulip. So what do you want to make? Let me make the chilies first. Chilies are quite super fast. So I'm just drawing a line like this. Okay. So you have to take the dark green color and hold it horizontal and just rub it against the paper. And now just give it a little shape. So little up and then immediately go down and make a pointy edge. Okay, so it already started looking like a chili. So I'm sure that many of you don't like green chilies. Okay, because it make our stomach also burn. They are hot. So green chili and Similarly, we can make red chili. So just take the color, red color, and now go up and then come down. So make a pointy edge. Okay. So the more you take the small size of the crayon, the more it will be better. Okay. So I'm making the stem of the. So just press little hard so that you get the bright colors. So I'm just making the stem for the red chili. See, this looks like a chili, right? Please use the chat box wisely. Don't send unnecessary message, okay? And try to focus on what we are trying to learn here, okay? We are here to learn something today, something new. So we have made a beautiful papaya and a strawberry and chilies, okay? So now we are moving on to the tulips. So I'll take the purple color. So this is my broken crayon and it's very small. So I'll just take it and I will make a tulip like this. So tulip is generally the U shape. So in the middle, it has a full petal like this and the side it is like this. Okay. So this is our tulip flower. So I hope everybody has understood how to make a tulip flower. So you just need to hold the crayon horizontal and rub it against the paper. So similarly, this is one flower, so you can make more flowers. I'm making only one flower. So now I'm making the stem of it. So you can just make the stem by dark green color and then you can just make a leaf with the green color crayon like this. Okay, so one more leaf I'm making. So it is like this. Okay, so now I'm going to make a lotus. So take a small crayon. See, I don't know whether you guys have a broken crayons or not. Don't break your crayons. This is just to give you an idea how to make use of the old crayons. Okay, so I'm going to make a rose here, lotus here. So this is my lotus and this is the another line. So just press little hard so it will give you the impression of the color. So from here again go up and then come down and just make the another petal like this. So you can see that we are making another flower. So you can make just one more petal. So you have to press little hard like this. Okay, and then just make another petal in the downward direction, because if you see the lotus, they have petals like this. Okay, so you can just press it little hard so that you can get the proper shape and little dark color. Okay, so I'm just repeating the procedure so that it becomes little dark. So our lotus has come out beautifully. It looks quite good. And I hope everybody is able to make it. So I'm just making the stem of the lotus with the green color. And there is a leaf at the bottom. So you can just make a leaf of the lotus like this. And you can just make the water with the light blue color. So the lotus is in the water. So this is how it looks. And I hope everybody has enjoyed today's session. So if you guys have any doubt, then ask me. Okay. Yeah, it looks like a lotus. This one is not lotus. This is tulip. This is lotus. You can see the difference. Okay, so you can just make two more leaves here. So tulip, if you will see, they are generally U-shaped. Okay. So,
bye everyone. Hope you had a wonderful session.